Dana White has now created a fight that we have to watch. He didn't give us a choice. You always have a choice. Is there anticipation here? Am I free that day? Is that a fight I'm looking forward to? Who's fighting? Is there a grudge match? What's at stake? What's on the line? Those are the things that drive this industry. Dana has now created one that we don't have a choice and we have to watch because history could be made. Derrick Lewis, who is the number two contender, who on paper and stylistically, and I don't mean to put the guy down, but he does not stand a chance with Daniel Cormier. On paper, I'm just talking about when you look at some of the cardio deficits that he has spoken about and we have seen with our own eyes, when you talk about some of the wrestling deficits that he has spoken about and we have seen with our own eyes, that's just not a good matchup. That is not a commentary on Derrick Lewis or his skills or his standing at the top of the division. It just means don't put him in there with Daniel Cormier. Derrick Lewis is an 8-1 underdog. Why does 8-1 sound familiar? Oh, perhaps because it's the same amount of odds that TJ Dillashaw was when he left with the world championship. 8-1. Why is that relevant? Oh, because it's very close to 7-1, which is what Holly Holm was, an underdog, when she was supposedly a lamb walking into slaughter, and she left with a world championship. 8-1 underdog for Derrick Lewis. Why does that matter? Because it's half the odds that Buster Douglas was underdog the night he walked into Tokyo, Japan and stopped somebody named Mike Tyson, and he left with his world championship. Meaningful fights, historical fights that everybody has seen, and a good number of the population got to see them live and witness it in real time, and the rest of the population had to go back and watch it after the fact because they kicked themselves for not seeing it in real time because they were historically meaningful. I will not present to you guys in any terms that I think Derrick Lewis has a chance, and not because I don't think he's great. I just want to get that out of the way. That's not what it is. I think Derrick Lewis got his ass kicked in his last fight. That's what I saw. I saw him get kind of dominated, as a matter of fact, in his last fight until he won with that one big punch. But he got dominated with some wrestling. I was stunned how Volkan was able to take him down, pass, get the side mount. I was equally as impressed how Derrick Lewis was able to explode. And it was just explosion. I even questioned some of his technique, but I did not question its effectiveness. And get back up. He got back up off the bottom. Well, I got no problem with that. If a guy is easy to take down, but he's hard to hold there, it's a bit of a wash. I have no problem with that. I'm just then juxtaposing that with Daniel Cormier's skills and sharing with you guys that I do not think there is a lot to see here. But boy, I wouldn't miss it. I would not miss it. And I don't think that the narrative of a puncher's chance is totally accurate when it comes to this match. This is not the biggest guy that Daniel Cormier has ever faced, though that's being said that it is. It's actually not. Derrick Lewis cuts to the heavyweight limit. So did Roy Nelson at the time Daniel took him on. So while Daniel has not fought anybody bigger, he has fought in a guy this big. And I also would push back on the narrative of the puncher's chance. Daniel Cormier, I don't think, will be hit as hard in this fight or ever again in his career as he was hit by Rumble Johnson. I only offer you guys that because then you got to look at, okay, well, what is Derrick Lewis going to do? Those are the obvious ones. People always look at, oh, well, you know, it's a size thing, and then you got the puncher's chance with the big power. Yeah, man, Derrick Lewis hits harder than hell, and yes, he has the size. But the other part about Derrick Lewis is he's hard to go away. I mean, that guy, he doesn't give up in there. He doesn't go out there and beat himself. He stays in the fight, and he stays in the fire. He became the number two ranked guy in the UFC for a reason. But a lot of those skills are sloppy, and a lot of it is made up with heart. He's tough, and he's a brawler. But I don't know that he is anywhere near the technical capacities of a Daniel Cormier. When you want to start building fights and you want to start talking about intangibles, though, Daniel has been very open that one of his hands hurts. I think that it is relevant. I think that it is more relevant than Daniel will let on in the next few days. I think that he's got a bum hand. I will just tell you that that will stop a striker a lot more than it will a grappler. Grapplers can have hurt hands. They can have wrapped up hands, taped up hands. Their fingers are always taped together. They don't need their hand as much as a boxer, where that's his only tool. So I think that Daniel will just be able to change his skill set, and I think that that hurt hand is a real thing. I think that that will be downplayed in the next few days because you have some politics there with commissions. But I think that you do need to observe it because I think that's going to tell us one thing, that Daniel is going to do more grappling than he does striking. I think he's going to look to get a hold of Lewis quickly. Daniel has a history of pushing guys into the fence and wearing on them before he drags them to the ground. I think that's what he looks to do. And I think when we know that that's what Daniel is going to look to do, I think that it does open up opportunity for Derrick Lewis to land some of those shots. And as much as I want to tell you, Daniel can take them, and I think that I'm right. That doesn't mean he wants to. Not very many trees are chopped down with one swing of the axe. You hit that tree over and over and over and over and take little chunks away. That's what the great fighters do, and that's what happens in the great fights. I think Derrick Lewis is going to have those opportunities. I tell you that because there's no part of me here that wants to piss all over Derrick Lewis. I just don't want to lose the narrative of this fight. The fact of how this fight was made and the fact that we must watch this fight because the odds are so ridiculous and because according to the odds maker, Derrick Lewis has no opportunity, which is the same thing they told TJ. It's the same thing. I was part of this. I was part of the people that told it to Holly. And all of us were guilty of telling it to Buster Douglas. We have to see this fight.